We announced a statewide policy for our schools. We did it last March 18th. We said that we were going to close schools all across the state, K to 12 and higher education schools. We waived what was called the 180-day requirement, which was a state regulation that schools had to have 180 days of teaching. Schools then transferred to distance learning programs, meal delivery services, child care options for essential workers. That has actually worked out well, not perfectly. We had to do it in a rush, but there are lessons that we can learn here that could change teaching going forward and teaching in these types of situations going forward. But it did work. It basically functioned well. And teachers did a phenomenal job stepping up to do this. It was a hardship on everyone, but we made the best of the situation. Colleges and universities were also moved to distance learning. Campuses were closed unless a student really needed housing on the campus. Schools, obviously, by definition, have higher density. They have transportation issues, kids who are getting on a bus. We didn't have the protective measures to put in place. You have 700 public school districts, 4,800 schools in this state. Then you have 1,800 private schools, 89 SUNY and CUNY campuses, 100 private colleges, and total is 4.2 million students. So the decisions on the education system are obviously critically important. We must protect our children. Every parent, every citizen feels that. We must protect our students. We have to protect our educators. So we're going to have the schools remain closed for the rest of the year. We're going to continue the distance learning programs. Schools have asked about summer school and whether we'll have attendance in schools for summer school. That decision will be made by the end of this month. Again, nobody can predict what the situation is going to be 3-4 weeks from now. So we're trying to stage decisions at intervals that give us the information, but also enough time for people to make the preparations they need to make. So any decisions on summer schools will be made by the end of this month. But in the meantime, meal programs will continue. The child care services for essential workers will continue. And then we want schools to start now developing a plan to reopen. And the plan has to have protocols in place that incorporate everything that we are now doing in society and everything that we learn. We're going to be asking businesses to come up with plans that safeguard workers when they reopen. We need schools to come up with plans also.